2005. Okay, so after that we haven't discussed anything, right? So now let me connect to this virtual machine remotely. This is my virtual machine. Okay, let me connect this virtual machine remotely. IP config. So 192.168.43.23. Okay, 43.23 is there. Connect. So today we'll see once we have installed SQL Server, what kind of changes will happen in the server, Windows server, what kind of folders are going to be created in the Windows machine, how many services are going to be installed in the Windows machine, how to connect to the default instance, how to change the service account. Okay, these things and all we are going to discuss in today's class, right? Okay, so this is my virtual machine. Okay, in this virtual machine I have installed Windows Server 2008 R2. Okay, on top of this Windows Server 2008 R2, I have installed SQL Server 2005. Later, tomorrow or in the next week, I'll show you how to install SQL Server 2012 also. Okay, right. So once we have installed SQL Server 2005 in that machine, in the Windows Server, what kind of new changes will happen in the Windows machine, right? So some folders are going to be created once we have installed SQL Server 2005 or any SQL Server, not only 2005. Once we have installed SQL Server in the machine, some new folders are going to be created. So where I can see those new folders, what kind of new folders are going to be created? So if you just open this my computer, this is the local machine, my computer. This is start. Okay, go to the my computer. So once you just go to this my computer, I have only C drive, right? In the virtual machine, I have only C drive. Double click on it, you can see program files. Okay, see program files. A folder will be created with the name of Microsoft SQL Server. Once you have installed the SQL Server in the machine, a folder will be created with Microsoft SQL Server. Not only with Microsoft SQL Server, whenever you install any new software, any other softwares like antivirus or else any other softwares or else any tools, once you have installed those tools, you can see a folder will be created with those software names. Okay, so like that only Microsoft SQL Server folder is created. Once you just open this folder, you can see there are three folders. One is 80, one is 90, one is mssql.1. okay, so till this location, okay, till this location, what we are going to call this location, instance base directory, C program files, Microsoft SQL Server. Till this location, we are going to call this location control Z. Oh, I have an issue. Okay, no problem. Let me open Notepad here. Okay, till this location, this location is called Microsoft instance root directory. Okay, this location is called instance root directory. Yes, okay, so once you just go into the any of the folders, okay, this is your mssql.1. what is the difference between these number folders and this name folder? This is called instance, sorry, this is your instance base directory, not root directory, instance base directory. Okay, so this is your instance root directory, instance root directory. If you just go to this location, this is your instance root directory. And we have one more location, number folder location is there, right? So that is called instance binaries. This 8090 is there, right? This location is called instance binaries. Instance binaries. Okay, so what will be there in the instance base directory? You can see instance binaries and instance root directory will be there in the instance binary. Okay, so if you go to instance root directory, all your data files and all your log files are going to be stored in this instance root directory. See, if you can see data folder, okay, this is very important folder. In the data folder only, if you doesn't specify any proper location, if you doesn't specify any location, okay, for storing data files and log files, by default those data files and log files are going to be stored in instance root directory, and in that MS SQL folder will be there. If you go inside MS SQL folder, there are lot of folders. In that folder, data folder will be there. If you go to this data folder, there you can see all your system databases, data files and log files. We have already discussed that database is a collection of two files. One is data file and another one is log file. Okay, so without these data files and log files, database will not be existed or will not be created. So if you go to any database, this is master database data file, and this is master database log file. This is model database data file, model database log file, MSDB data file, MSDB log file, and we have one more data file, which is a resource database. We have a separate class on system databases. Okay, we have a separate class on system databases. We have five types of system databases. So which system database will do what kind of functionality? Master will do what kind of functionality? What is the use of the model? What is the use of the MSDB? What is the use of the TempDB? What is the use of the resource DB? We are going to discuss all these things in a separate session, right? So this location, usually we are going to store that particular data files and log files of all the databases, even not only for system databases. If you create any user database also, by default, if you don't specify any path to data file and log file, by default, that user database data file and log file are going to store in this location. So data folder is very important. In the data folder, you can see data files and log files of all the databases, right? So backup, this is your backup location. In this backup location, okay, this is also default backup location. This is also default backup location. While taking the backups of the databases, by default, those backup files will go to this location. If you specify any alternate location, of course that backup files will go to that location. If you doesn't specify any location for backups, by default those backup files will be saved in this backup location. Okay, and this is another folder called binen folder. In this binen folder, so actually what happens is, whenever you install a SQL server, there are lot of files will be copied from that software. You will install SQL Server by using the software, right? That ISO image, right? So in that ISO image, lot of files will be there. What kind of files will be there? Okay, DLL files, dynamic link library files, dynamic link library, RLL files. RLL files means resource link library files, resource link library. Okay, and MSI files, MSI.msi files, Microsoft installer files, Microsoft installer files. Okay, and MSP files, Microsoft patch files. Okay, and .manifest files, .manifest files. So this file is a starting point of the installation. Manifest files is a starting point of the installation. This file only knows what kind of files we have to copy, with which file I have to start the installation. Everything will be stored in this .manifest files. Okay, so like that, we have different kinds of extensions files will be copied. Yes, you can see here. Okay, ICO file, dot ICO file, dot INF file. ICO means icon file, information file, dynamic link library files, resource link library files, HTA means HTML application files, manifest file, it's an entry point of a files. Okay, Next is cabinet file and MSI MSP files. These two are important. MSI MSP, these two are very important usually. So in the interview, they will ask, while installing the SQL Server, did you get any errors? Yes. Okay, sometimes, not every time. Okay, if it is a new box, if it is a new server, usually you will not get any errors. 99% is you will not get any errors. Mostly if you get like kind of permission kind of errors, you will get. But if it's an old box, if you're trying to install SQL Server on an old Windows server, if you are trying to install SQL Server on an old Windows machine, in that case, you will get MSI MSP missing errors. So what is this MSI MSP missing errors? MSI MSP missing files, usually if you want to install as per the Windows architecture, this Windows Server as well as Microsoft SQL Server, both are belongs to Windows only, means Microsoft only. So as per the Windows architecture, if you want to install any software in the Windows machine, all the softwares will have MSI files. Okay, MSI files. Starting, you will get MSI files. Once you just patch that particular software, once you updated that particular software, then you will get MSP files. Okay, sometimes what happens is these two files will be missed. See, remember one thing, MSI means MSI MSP means not two files. Different kinds of MSI MSP files will be there. Lot of MSI MSP files will be there. See here, once I'll show you. Okay, go to this machine. In your local machine also you can see. Okay, just simply type .msi. Okay, so if you can't see here .msp, as of now you can see only DLL and RLL files here in this bin and location. You can see only DLL and RLL files. I'll show you MSI MSP files also. If you see, all the extensions will be .dll, .local, .exe local. Okay, so you can see here. Right, so these are all the different files which will support of SQL Server. Okay, see here, this is very important. If your SQL Server is running, okay, in this bin and location, you can see .exe files also. Okay, so if you want to, say for example, if your SQL Server is running, any software is running, background, in the background some processes will run. Okay, in the same way, if your SQL Server is running, in the background there are lot of processes will run. In that, the main process is this one, SQL Server. Usually if you can see, this is not server, sql server, this process will run in the background, then only your SQL Server will be up and running. If this exe file is not running in the background, okay, your SQL Server will not be up and running. Where I can see that one, just go to task manager. Okay, here go to processes. Okay, so if you can see here SQL Server is here, you can see, right, SQL Server.exe. This process should be up and running, then only your SQL Server will be up and running. Otherwise, if this process is stopped by someone, if anyone just click on this end process, then your SQL Server will not be up and running, and you cannot connect to the SQL Server also. So like this kind of exe files, lot of exe files will be there. For each and every process, some exe files will be there. Those exe files will be stored in the bin and location. Okay, just go outside. Right, this data folder we have already discussed, right? And this is a full text data, FT data. As of now, nothing will be there in this. Okay, some supported files will be there. Okay, and install folder, in the install folder you can see some of the scripts. These are all default script and standard scripts. Okay, so we are not going to use these default scripts and all. And jobs related information and all, you can see here in the jobs location. As of now, nothing is there. And this is log folder. So what is this log folder? This is also very important. Okay, so what is this log folder means? SQL Server, whenever SQL Server is up and running, SQL Server will track each and everything. SQL Server will track each and everything. Why? Because if something happened to the SQL Server, we have to know, right, what happened to the SQL Server, why it is not working, what is the problem. Okay, log. Log means what? If you go to any library, usually if you go to any library, there will be a logbook. If you go to any apartment kind of thing, there will be a logbook. What we are going to write in the logbook? What is your name? From which location you came? Okay. What is the purpose? What is your mobile number? Everything about your details you are going to write down in the logbook, right? In the same way, whenever SQL Server is up and running, from that first minute, first second onwards, whenever SQL Server is starting, from that first second onwards, SQL Server will track each and everything in the error log file. SQL Server will track each and everything in the error log file. Those error log file physical location files you can find in the log folder. Okay, those error log file, we have five error log files, error log, and 1, 2, 3, 4, total five error log files will be there. These five error log files will be stored in the log folder. You cannot delete these error log files. If you delete, you can delete it. If you simply stop the SQL Server, then you can delete this one. But it's not a good option to delete these error log files. Don't change anything. Don't try to delete anything from this location. Error log is very important to track the SQL Server, okay, functionalities, right? So any issues, any doubts? This is a different folder, a replication folder. If you just configure replication in your SQL Server, I'm going to explain about this Repl data folder, okay? So any issues, any doubts till now, just let me know. Otherwise, I'll proceed. Madhu, sorry, dot, I can't hear you properly. Yeah, SQL Server dot exe.
We can able to see in SQL Server configuration
manager. SQL Server configuration manager, you cannot see in the SQL Server dot exe. You can see only in this bin and location and in the task manager. If you want to see, say for example, if you go to task manager, sorry, not task manager, configuration manager, Microsoft SQL Server, and if you go to this configuration tools, you can see configuration manager here. This is your configuration manager. You can see the processes only. Okay. So go to the SQL Server services. Right, this is your main source. Okay, main service. This is your main service. Right click, properties. Okay, service. Binary path location you can see. Okay, SQL Server.exe. Here location of that SQL Server.exe file location you can see here. Okay, where you can find that particular SQL Server.exe file, you can see here. But the location we have already discussed, right? This location, MS SQL binen, there you can see SQL Server.exe, right? So the location of the file will be there in that particular configuration manager. Where we can find the SQL Server.exe, that location you can find in the configuration manager. Clear?
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, right.
Shanmugji.
Yeah.
Hello?
Yeah.
Where we can find the MSI and MSP files?
Yeah, I'll show you. MSI and MSP files also, I'll show you. Okay, so this is our instance root directory. This is the discussion on instance root directory. We have discussed all these folders, right? Right. Now let me go out. Okay. So just go to instance base directory. This is my instance base directory. And go to instance binaries. Okay. If you go to instance binaries also, there you can see some of the MSI and MSP files. Okay. Right. So here, if you go here and just simply type dot MSI. Here, let me show you our C program files. We can find that MSI MSP files. One minute. Okay. I'll show you some. Here only it will be there. Here or here. Show you. there are lot of MSI and MSP files will be there. Okay, lot of MSI and MSP files will be there. These are all MSI folders only. Okay. This is very old machine. The controls will be different in the old server. Okay. See here. Okay. See here, rsfx.msi, master data services.msi. It is still getting the details. Yeah. Okay. SQL ncli.msi, SQL support.msi. So these are all different MSI files. See here, lot of MSI files will be there. These are all .msi files only. SQL dom.msi. Sometimes you will get this kind of error. Okay. SQL DOM file is missing. Okay. In that case, what you have to do is you have to download the SQL DOM from the Google and you have to simply install that SQL DOM so that it is going to be fixed. I'll tell you in the upgradation concept, I'll tell you about the SQL DOM file. Okay. So these are all your MSI and MSP files. You can see here. Okay. So this is my local machine. That is Windows Server 2008 R2. Okay, which we have discussed. That is different machine. This is my local machine. In my local machine also I have installed SQL Server, right? So those MSI files, and if you just simply check MSP files also, you can see lot of MSP files. Okay, so these are your .msp files, right? Usually you can find it in the C program files, Microsoft SQL Server only. Let me go to the properties of this file. And if you go to the location, see here in the 100 folder means what? Binary folder. In the setup bootstrap folder, you can find this one, setup bootstrap folder. We have a setup bootstrap. I'll show you setup bootstrap folder also. I'll show. So like this, you can see. So sometimes what happens is these files accidentally, someone will delete these files. Okay. Windows people, what they will do, knowingly or unknowingly, what they will do is they will delete these MSP files. Okay, or while doing this housekeeping maintenance activities. Okay, so while doing these kind of maintenance activities also, automatically these files will be deleted. If it is a new machine, no issue. Okay, if it is an old machine, okay, if these files are deleted, then again if you want to install SQL Server, what it will, while installing the SQL Server, while patching the SQL Server, okay, these files should be there. So if someone deleted these 5 MSP files or 6 MSP files, okay, so while patching, it will check for all these 5 MSP files. If this file is there, it will update that particular file. If this file is not there, patching will be failed, saying this MSP is missing or this MSI is missing, or installation also will be failed, saying this MSP or MSI is missing. Okay, so that's why usually not on the new machines, but while installing SQL Server, while patching the SQL Server, while upgrading the SQL Server also, usually the most common error is MSI MSP missing errors. So how to fix that MSI MSP missing errors? Okay, so how to fix that MSI MSP missing errors? Okay, just 1 minute. This meeting is going to close in 1 minute. Okay, what I'll do, I'll again open the meeting, just join again. Okay, let me close and let me open the meeting again. Just again, how you join, just like that only, join the meeting again. Okay.